Say nobody cares, someone cares, just not you. And let's be for real, no one cares for you. Thank you. Someone cares. I know that much, but probably not you. Okay. Vinyls. Well, not vinyls, records. Records, guys. Records, records, records. I got some records, okay? We are the world. We are the world record. Prince. I don't know if I want to show the front. Because, I mean, you kind of saw the front, right? It's not showing. You know, hold on. Just for this moment, for this occasion, for a little bit, okay? Look. My hair can just block some of that. Anyways. Prince. The Wiz, guys. I got the Wiz. I got the Doobie Brothers. Because, Doobie Brothers. My favorite. This is unopened. The Spice Girls. I got the Spice Girls. We may already have this one. And I was not thinking. But the Police. Fleetwood Mac. Lion King. So the Wiz was the Broadway one, and this is the movie version one. So this one is the movie version of the Wiz with Diana Ross, Michael Jackson, Nipsey Russell, and I forget who plays the lion, and then Richard Pryor, he played the what do you call it? What did he play? He played, I can't even remember. The Wizard. That's what it was, the Wizard. When he's like, pay no attention to the man behind the mask or something like that. And then he's like, anyways. Every time I try to watch The Wiz, I fall asleep. I know people are gonna be like, don't put it back on. I am. Okay? I don't know why. Every time I watch The Wiz, I have a habit of sleeping. And no, I did not pay what prices it says on these records. So I want people to be like, oh my God, you spent a lot of money. You're supposed to be saying, okay, I didn't pay. Okay, we got deals on these. Okay, we asked for deals. Because I know how people get about me spending money. It's like, ah! Okay, so zip it. They were having a thing downtown at the Al Ray Theater, and they were doing where they sold records and tapes and stuff like that. I wanted to show you that tape, but it's over there. But it's actually, let me get it for you. My brother saw it, right? And of course, for the price, it was a little pricey, not gonna lie. But it was two. Tapes, and we couldn't pass it up because you never find this tape. So, yeah. It is Life After Death. The Notorious B.I.G. It is two tapes. You rarely find this. This in this. So, yeah. It's life after death. Do you even have a cassette player? Yes! My brother has the record player that he has plays tapes and it plays CDs. So, yeah, we went somewhere today. And then Monday is exciting. I'm not telling you guys what I did, but I did something Monday. And we'll see how well that goes. Hopefully, you know, money makes money. Right? I did something important that I had to do. That I have to check Monday, so I'm tired. Kind of fucking crap. Yes, that's what I want is money, okay? You mean is that all I want? Yes, because look at where I'm living. I need money to get out of here, and clearly I don't know how that's gonna be possible. I didn't spend a lot of money on those vinyls, by the way. What the prices are on those, I didn't spend that because I'm not spending $40 on one vinyl. That's just outrageous. It's just that with what I have coming in, and I have So I got an MTV shirt. It's just a red with like black and white MTV. I'll get it for you. And then a Pikachu shirt. There was another one that I saw that I wanted. It was Boys in the Hood. But this guy, he prints and makes his own shirts. And I was gonna ask him, but then I forgot. And anyways, how he makes his shirts, cause I was wearing this Selena shirt, right? And he's like, I print, and he was like, I made this shirt, and it was a Selena shirt, like her last performance at the Astrodome. And so, yeah, we have a place, but so I've explained this to people. It's difficult. We have to go down there I just got over being sick, right? And so we have to go down there and fill out the application and try to get in. But the truck, okay, so we didn't have a truck for 2 days. I had to fork out money to help fix the truck because my brother had, I don't really want to say too much information. Money's coming in now, mind you. Money's coming in now, but I don't want to give too much information. We have a place. So all the apartments that we have to go down there and fill out an application. We can't because we don't have transportation. I can't go by bus because I was sick. And now that I'm feeling a little better, I don't know. We can't leave Hershey by herself and someone has to go with me. Plus also we have to have proof of income. And I don't know, I don't wanna go all the way down there for nothing. They may accept my taxes, but at this point the only income we have is technically, well, we have two incomes now actually. Yeah, as a matter of fact, we have two. Never mind. So, the one place that we have to go to, we're gonna go. We didn't have a car, a truck. I helped buy parts for the truck because he needed it for work and stuff. Hershey, be quiet. And so we needed it for work. Shh. Hershey. No. Also, someone, Hershey, be quiet. Hershey. Someone said, send me money to say hi to AJ. I forgot. Hi, AJ. Anyways, Hershey. Hey, Hershey, stop. You're annoying. Hershey. Hey, stop. Jesus Christ. Anyways, I was gonna say something else. Some people sent me some money in Cash App. One person sent for snacks, to get snacks. So I ordered some Insomnia cookies. It's like the crumb cookie place, but they were for the same price that I was gonna pay. I just got Insomnia cookies because the same price was, I was gonna get 6 cookies, and Insomnia cookies, I got like 13 cookies. It was a little over, but 13 cookies because DoorDash fees. But someone was like, get yourself some snacks. So I was like, okay. And, through my Cash App. And so I tried their cookies. And they were pretty great, but for the price, I don't know. It was good. I liked it. I would order from them again because of s'mores cookies. But, yeah. When I was live, someone sent it, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna order some cookies, and that's what I did. So. Why did I buy cookies? Because someone sent me money to get snacks. When someone write, like, you know how you could write like a message on Cash App? When someone tells you to do something with what they're sending it, I can only use that for what they gave it to me for, right? So I used it to get snacks, and I got us some cookies because I wanted to try it. And also because my mom really liked those cookies, the ones that I picked out for her. But anyways, so I don't know if I showed you this shirt, but I got Pikachu. It says Feel Electric. It's kind of looks like 80s throwback. And then Hershey has dog food. Here's a new bag of dog food. Oh, Hershey. See? Had a great view. Smell of dog food. Okay. And then, I got this MTV shirt because I've always wanted and needed an MTV shirt. So, I got MTV. Because I don't really have clothes. And I don't know what we're gonna. I have to. It's really hard because I have to wash stuff by hand. They have a washer and dryer here, but it takes card. And I don't want to risk putting my card in and then it takes the money. Then we have to wait a long time for the money to get back on the card. And I don't know, with laundry machines that take cards, sometimes it takes your money. So, yeah, that's stressful. I had change because I was walking down. I was gonna take all the stuff and take the change, and then I noticed that the thing doesn't take change, and I was like, bro, And where we lived last, it took credit card, but the machines didn't work. The only machines that worked were the washers, and there we would have to bring our clothes at home and dry them outside. And so, I have to wash everything in the sink. And so, yeah. Otherwise, this thing that I'm doing Monday, oh, that's what I was going to talk about, AI. There's this app, okay, there's, well, not app, there's this thing, it's only $8, so what's $8, right? I was gonna edit some things and do some stuff, but, so this guy does, is it backdrop? I don't know what it is. It's like, infinite backdrop or something. I don't know what it's considered. But, so it gives you your own personal printed picture AI. Whatever you type in, it's, I know someone, I think someone did this on their clothing. So anyways, you pay and it's your own image. It's your own personal generated, image that you can use and sell, right? But see, for me personally, I want to do my own artwork. I really don't want to pay for it. But I was thinking on getting ideas on some stuff through that. Maybe using a couple. And re-editing the stuff for like clothing and stuff. Obviously, I'm probably going to have to do it on the print-on-demand place. Because I don't know what you call it, not a vendor. Someone said a vendor, but I don't think it's a vendor. You know, like a manufacturer that like people could order through them and then they send the deliveries. It's like that. It's like that. That was my mom, but not Etsy. Etsy, you gotta pay extra fees. It's just a hassle. If I was to sell anything, most likely probably through Shopify. But Shopify, you get like one, okay, so you get one free trial for Shopify. So, my nose is bothering me. Thank you for the gift points. So, I have to work on that. Why do I sound congested? Because I am congested. So, I'm going to be working on some stuff. So, yeah. Yep. Wasting money on other things now. The thing is that I've been seeing what people have been saying. And it's hurtful. Makes me sad. I wish people could understand how hard it is to get into an apartment. It's not easy. No, I'm not gonna cry. Sorry, my nose. My nose is bugging me. I'm not gonna cry. Ooh, my nose. Jesus Christ, you guys. My nose is really bothering me. Oh, Lord. Oh. can't even. It's just congested. And anyways, so it's very difficult. And since my income was basically the only income, like, I'm trying not to say all of my business. I'm trying not to, because it's no one's business. Thank you for the owl. But yeah, right now, I don't know, we're just stuck here for now until we at least have a proof of income to get in somewhere. And even then, we still gotta wait. Even then. No, thank you for the point. Stop giving me money. Wow. TikTok takes like 50% of that, so. And these are like 1 cent. Whatever the roses are is like 1 cent.
Get out of my
spot. Like, I don't know. How's out the file taxes? And what's hurtful is that people say that I didn't pay for necessities. I had to pay the cell phone bill. I also had to put gas in my brother's truck. I had to pay for truck parts, and I also had to pay for storage. Me. Not anybody else. Me. And I had to pay for this room too. Out of my money, I paid for this room. It's $320 a week and it's difficult. And it's already, Jesus Christ, it's already almost been a week. Gonna have to pay Tuesday. It's just frustrating. It really is. That's a lot of money. I needed my phone because I used my phone, so I had to pay that. No, my brother's gonna be able to start helping, but not for a while. And Monday, I did something Monday, so we'll see. We'll see how well that does. If it does well, then I'll start doing more of that. I don't wanna say anything because people are rude and negative and they wish horribly on me, so. Yeah. I saw this comment section and people are rude. And they proved her right. They proved her right. They did. So this girl, someone sent me the video. This girl used me as an example. Thank you for the whale. This girl used me as an example to say that people are always looking for the strong black woman to target, right? And used me as an example because she put me in the hashtag. And I saw one comment and it sucks. I can't, like, okay. It bothers me that I can't say anything because TikTok is getting strict. Let's just be honest. TikTok is getting really strict. I don't know if you guys know. Guys, be careful. They don't have they don't have community guidelines anymore. You mess up once and you get a strike and your account's already on permanently banned, okay? If you get one strike, your account is at risk of being permanently banned. They don't give you a warning anymore. Comments will get you in trouble if you leave a not so nice comment. Doxing, they're not gonna allow that anymore. So all these people who are being rude, negative, nasty towards me are gonna have to be careful, because you don't get a warning, you will lose your account. Okay, TikTok, when they went to Congress, TikTok has gotten so strict to the point where I don't know. I feel like people are gonna leave TikTok. Like, that's just my honest opinion. TikTok is done for. They're hella strict. They're not even gonna give you a warning. You get one strike, and your account's at risk of being permanently banned. That's just what. I got a notification, right, about the community guidelines. There is no community guidelines. It's a strike guideline. So yeah, even if you have a green screen on, like some people green screen when they're driving, they know when you're driving. So if you're green screening while driving, they know, and they will give you a strike for that. So you can't green screen and drive. There's a whole bunch of like TikTok got very, very strict. So yeah, I have to be careful what I'm gonna say, because I really wanted to like tell these, you know, what I normally tell people in the comment section, but I can't do that anymore, because one person was like, be for real, she's not black. I'm sick and tired of people going into other people's pages and spreading this she's not black thing, and I can't defend myself. So now I'm supposed to just sit here and take it? Like, that's frustrating. Because that video someone sent me today, I believe it was sent today, I saw it, but the girl was literally saying that they look for a strong black woman to target and be racist towards, and she used me as an example, and it was nothing but people in her comment section saying, well, do you know what she did? Do you know, blah, blah. You just literally invalidated her voice, and you also made it seem like racism isn't happening. And that's what annoyed me, is that you sat there essentially telling her that racism isn't happening, because of the fact that what I've done bypasses what I have done bypasses other people and what they're doing in being racist. And the fact that you guys attack and target people who literally just make, she was just using me as an example, is crazy. Like, it has to stop at some point. You have to just let people defend me, and if you don't like it, oh well. There's no attacking or targeting or harassing or bullying people anymore. I'm sick of it. Like, one person, like I said, people thought it was me. They said, oh, it's you on your alt account, because the person told me. And I was like, they do that all the time because they don't think there's people that actually support me. And howdy, howdy, howdy. It's annoying. Like, that girl used me as an example. She's a black girl, and you invalidated her voice and just literally essentially told her, like, nah, that's not what's really going on. That is what's really going on. That's the issue. That's the problem on TikTok. People don't acknowledge how black people get treated on this app, and it's frustrating. And you still won't continue to acknowledge that. She's right. And I've been telling you guys this the whole time. You guys know what happened? That large content creator saw exactly a glimpse. And I'm not saying her, but there was this large content creator that saw a glimpse of how people treat me. And yet I have huge content creator saying that I treat my fans horribly, that I'm not nice to people, that I'm blah blah blah. I don't disrespect people who haven't disrespected me for no reason. You disrespect me, I'm gonna disrespect you. That's how it works. And it's annoying to me that they were saying that when they know nothing. When just yesterday, was it yesterday or the day before yesterday, I was on someone's live stream. We all know who that was. And they went on his live stream and right, they were like telling me to go live. One person got mad because I wouldn't go live. I said, I'll go live later. And they were like, go live now. Then they said, are you ready to effing die? Her soda. They said, are you ready to effing D-I-E, Tophia? And tagged me. Well, they didn't say Tophia, but they tagged my username on his live stream. And he saw that and he was like, whoa, 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 wait. And how it got bypassed, I don't know, because, like, let's be honest, if TikTok was strict, how did their comment go through? That's crazy that a comment like that goes through on someone's live stream. And all I was doing was just sitting there having a I was just sitting on my phone just watching, having a conversation, watching live battles, enjoying the live. And I'm sick of people also throwing little shades here and there in those live streams and be like, what are you doing here? Obviously, you should know why I'm there. If I wasn't allowed to be there, I would have been blocked. I'm tired of it. It's just annoying that people keep throwing light freaking shade every freaking where I go, saying like, what are you doing here? Why are you here? Leave me alone. If I want to watch a live stream, I can. You got a problem with it, you don't like me, just leave. No one's forcing you to be in a live stream with me. It's like you are mad that you have to exist in a live stream with me. You see, that person said that really hateful thing towards me on another person's live stream. And it frustrates me that all these people just follow me around and bully me wherever the heck I go. For no apparent reason. But yet I sit here and bully my fans. That I'm a horrible person who just bullies my fans. Like the song, the one part in Eminem where it's like, you're a mean, mean man. That's what people just make it seem like I am. And it's frustrating. It's annoying. I'm tired of it. I'm not mean. You know, it's okay for, sorry, my nose, darn it. It's okay for other people to sit here and literally say something like that on another live stream. But I'm the mean one. I'm the one who bothers everyone, right? Right? That's crazy. You know, some people take breaks and go on vacations and have an easy life. You don't have to worry about people harassing you on the daily. You don't go through what I go through. And for people to sit on a live stream and just talk about me is frustrating because stop. Like, it's annoying. It's like, bro, you sit here, thank you, and you just talk, and you talk, and you talk about me, and it's like, you don't pay attention like I do. I go around to live streams that I'm in, and I see what people are doing. I see what people are saying. I see the crap that people talk all the time. Like, you know, AK's live stream, when they always go to her live stream and be like, bring Tofu up every single live stream when it has nothing to do with me. And you want another live stream again. That's like you go around and you talk. You talk on everyone's live streams. You think I don't know, right? You say a bunch of stuff about me and I have to sit there and listen to it. And it's just like in the comment section, it gets frustrating. It's just like, it's just so annoying. You're always a drama all the time, but then you're on a, so-and-so is talking about you. She's talking about you. It's like, if these people would stop for a second, just talking about me, just not following me, you know, it would help. Nova is in my TikTok comment sections, not leaving me alone. in my Instagram story or Instagram pages, not leaving me alone, but going on live stream saying he hates me so much, but he doesn't have me blocked. Bro, if you hate me that much, just block me. Why are you following me around everywhere saying, I could care less if you hate me, okay? Go on your Twitch and say you hate me. Like, do I care? No. No one even freaking mentioned me, and out of nowhere you're like, I hate Tophia Chu. I hate Leslie. Like, no one mentioned me, bro. I live in your head rent free. Rent free. Like, you're in my comment section. You don't want to add people to your Discord because you feel they're going to troll you. That is a lie. You know you have something that you shouldn't have in your Discord, that you are hiding it. Let people in your Discord. Let them see what you have, because you won't. It is so frustrating and annoying that Nova just sits here and literally just talks all this crap and is still in my comment sections on my Instagram page and my TikTok. It is so annoying. Like, my TikTok, it is so annoying. Like, bro. And I know people are gonna be like, you just spent money. Like, stop right there. That's the thing we are not gonna do. I don't pocket watch people, but it's annoying when he's literally calling me a scammer, but he can't even complete his cameos. He can't even do cameos that have been sitting there for 3 months. And they're paying $70 a cameo. And did you even give that person their refund back? Or are you just like scamming people? Come on now. You can't just have cameos and you're not completing these cameos and you're taking their money. And then when he gets Nova, and then when he gets a strike, right? When he gets a strike, like when someone leaves a bad review, he says, I can't have that. Why can you not leave a bad review? Like, that's not how it works. You have to fix whatever issue it is that person had to have better cameos for the future. The cameo that the girl showed that she got was trash. Sorry. I care because people are getting scammed. I care because no one else should get scammed again, right? We have to prevent people from getting scammed. That's like me sitting here watching people get scammed by someone and not say anything. Hello? Like, this, and I care because this person called me a scammer when I didn't scam anyone. And they're the ones that are scamming. It sounds like projection. That's why I care also, because they called me a scammer. Like, don't call me a scammer if you're one. Like, all you do is talk about me, and no one mentions me, and I'm sick of it. Large content creators, or semi-large. She's so rude to her fans. Like, so rude. I'm very rude to my fans, I guess, apparently. And like I've always told people, I don't consider people fans. I consider people supporters. There's a difference. So, if people think I'm so rude to my fans, of course I'm so rude to my fans. I guess the DMs I got were a lie that says, you're not rude. You're nice to me when I join. You're nice to your supporters. And I'm like, exactly. But anytime someone talks about me, people just love eating it up. And they're like, yeah, she's so rude to her fans. It's just like every day I get a video. And this is like another thing. It's like I'm getting screen recorded videos on my For You page that just bothers me of me, and it's annoying. It's like she addressed the company, and it's like, who cares? Like, why did you need to screen record me talking about the agency? Like, what are you that crazy? Because let's be honest, do you guys know how much money these people are making off of me? It's crazy, because of the creator fund and the views they are getting. Once you get a certain, you have to have like 10,000 followers, I believe, and you have to have one video hit 100,000, and then you get into the creator fund. It's not that hard. So these people are literally making money off my videos. Like, it's annoying. There's nothing I can do about it. Not at this point. There's also, I don't know, there's too much going on that I can't handle at once, that I need a freaking team or something to take these accounts down because I'm frustrated. There is an account on Twitter where someone actually paid for a verification, and it's going around saying bigotry, racist type stuff to BTS about Nicki Minaj, about all these celebrities, and they're claiming to me. With my name, and I can't do anything about it. I don't know the full username. People said they typed it in and it didn't come up, so I don't know who did that. Someone did it to be malicious, so they used the C slur that is used towards Asians, and that's the reason why someone said people attacked me over the Jimin thing, and I was like, why am I getting attacked for playing Jimin when I didn't say that? And of course people are gonna say that's me because they don't like me, and obviously they're gonna say it's verified, and they're gonna say you can't pay for a verification. So now people are gonna think that's me because, you know, they don't like me, so, like, yeah. I don't know. That's crazy. They paid for a freaking verification, and so now the stupid account is verified and is leaving nasty comments under people's posts. And it's a very bad Twitter. It's not like the stuff people sent me from that Twitter is crazy. And I don't know. Also, I did get a message on here, and I want to say I'm not going on any more live streams. I'm not making any more videos. If you want to make videos about me, that's fine. I don't want people, say I'll pay you to come talk about your situation. I'm not doing that anymore. Guys, I'm not doing that anymore. I'm not. So yeah. It is stuffy in here, and my hands are sticky. So yeah. So. what happened. Oh, yeah, also, so the more subscriptions I get, the more free subscriptions I get. So right now, guys, I have 8 free subscriptions to give away to people if I wanted to, of my choosing. So right now, I have accumulated 8 free for my subscriptions. For whoever wanted to be subscribed, I have 8 free subscriptions to give away. Not now, but yeah, the more subscribers I got the other day, because I didn't know it was in subscription mode, I got 8 free subscriptions. So yeah, we're trying to get to 300. So I don't know. I was going to do sub live only mode, but the thing is that I can't play music in there because it says you cannot. So that's a problem, because you know, some days I want to just like not, kind of like stop people from being able to screen record, because it's annoying at this point, the screen recording. It's like screen recording all my live streams and then just posting it online. Every screen recorded live stream, they take a piece of the live and they post it, and it's getting frustrating. Like, I'm frustrated, you know. It's giving people content, and there's nothing I could do at this point, because obviously there's nothing I could do. Did someone say go live battle? Is that what it says? That's not how I get more viewers. I get more views myself. I don't need people making money off of me. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. My nose has been bothering me all day. They're making money, that's why I care, because they're getting views off of me. I have to care. I shouldn't let people make money off of me. Right?
Rover? No, the rover.
Why do you look sad today? I'm kind of a little sad. It's okay. Thank you for the subscriptions. My nose has been bugging me. We lost connection. wherever. I paid for my data because obviously it comes with the phone service, but I'm on the hotel's Wi-Fi. I'm not on my data. Are we back? Are we back? We are back. That girl loves to talk about black creators, but she never, ever, ever addressed Strange Karen. Strange Karen, sorry. I don't know why I was thinking Karen, because that's the girl that was talking about Aunt Karen. And frankly, I don't care about House of Mama. House of Mama goes around and is in so much drama talking crap about everyone, but never about herself and how she is anti-black or she is racist, and she held a space for black women to attack other black women, and she has just been a problem. She even had Strange Kevin on her live, literally defending Strange Kevin, and that girl is annoying to me. Literally. Like, I don't know why she's talking about me. I never said anything to her. Like, you know, people are going to talk because I had 4,000 people in my live stream. It's just so annoying because people are going to be like, look, she bought records and she's living in a room and she's not. You see the problem that happens when you guys say that I don't do the important stuff? Because it causes people like that to say that I'm a scammer when clearly I'm not a scammer. Like I said, I spent $5, wow, on a record. Ooh, like, some of those records were $1, wow. Like, if I didn't have change. Like, if I'm just spending money instead of, like, not doing what I need to do. That's the problem that happens when you guys literally sit here and say stuff. Because then it causes other people to pick it up and be like, look, this person is live and they get a lot of viewers and they're scamming people because people are sending them a bunch of gift points when I don't ask for it. I just sit here. And all I have to do, darn it, my nose is just like, I just sit here and that's what I have to deal with. Whatever it is, I don't know, because I'm pretty sure that's most likely what it is. People are probably going to other large content creators and being like, she's scamming. She bought a bunch of records because, you know, she bought a couple t-shirts. Whoa. Like, you know, this is why I try not to share things with people, but I was excited because I got a lot of nice records for cheap. And one of the records I got really, really cheap is actually a rare record, which I didn't know, from Prince, that I gave to my mom because, you know, whatever. So what if I bought dollar records? It's a dollar. And The Wiz on Broadway was free. Because what happened was it had the tag 50 cents, right? And so I was like, I didn't have change in my, I had like cat, like, cash, like cash. I didn't have like change. And so I had bought albums. So I didn't have anything left. And it said like 50 cents. And so I was like, you know what? I was like, dang it, I don't have 50 cents. So then my brother asked him like, how much is this? And he's like, oh, you can have that. And so we got a free record. Victory, good clean victory before I go to sleep. Thank you so much, guys. Why did I think he was getting undressed on live? Is my brain. Oh, Jesus, Lord, my brain, my nose, I don't feel good. My nose keeps bothering me. Not the aviator glasses. You look. Anyways, no, I don't know them. I only know House of Mama because she's the one who's been talking about it on Karen. And I've seen her live stream. She had Strange Karen on. I mean, I keep saying Strange Karen because I'm mentioning Strange Kevin. And she was defending Strange Kevin. Looks so differently with brown hair. I wish my hair didn't look black on camera. I have reddish brown hair. It looks black. Like, that's disappointing. I don't have black hair. Alright, Jungkook is not here. Why do you keep commenting? That's annoying. records, albums. Lies. He's not here. Thought I put something else. I don't know, there's just... I really want to dye my hair, but if I have to bleach it, and I don't want to do that because... Wherever we're meant to be together, I'll be there and you'll be near. And that's the deal, my dear. Wherever, whenever we're meant to be together, I'll be there and you'll be near. And that's the deal, my dear. Sorry. That song stuck in my head now. People just have been sending me random live streams. Turn around, every now and then I get a little. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. You're cheating. No one is live. That's a lie. Whenever, wherever, we're meant to be together, I'll be there and you'll be near, and that's the deal, my dear. Wherever, whenever, we're meant to be together. Hershey. What's my hair routine? I've been using this Shea Moisture shampoo. It's really good. Shea Moisture. And then I use the Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie. I have taken care of the dog. Huh, Hearthy? Who asked that? I don't know who asked. Hershey, no. I kind of like that copper color. That guy has anger issues. He's screaming for no reason. And the lady said, shut up. That's funny. Hussey, come here. Come here. You can't see Hershey because she's growling. Have you paid my bills? Yes. I have. Wherever, whenever we're meant to be together, I'll be there and you'll be near. And that's the deal, my dear. And my nose is getting itchy. I'm still living. What kind of a question is that? I'm still living, guys. Sadly, yes, I'm still living. What kind of a question was that? You're still living? That really makes people feel good. I was like, wait, there is no way that this live stream has been going on for that long. I can help you. Oh, I didn't mean to. How old am I? I am 28. I'm gonna be 29 this year. And I just realized something that literally crushed my entire soul. Is that this year is the last year I will be in my 20s. And I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. We don't claim you as Mexican. Listen, someone said stop trying to be Mexican. I'm not trying to be Mexican. Just, oh my God. Because I'm wearing a Selena shirt, I'm trying to be Mexican when Selena was Mexican American. Like, oh my God, help. I've been listening to Selena since I was 10. I'm not allowed to listen. Like, this is the type of gatekeeping that I hate, because let's be honest. You know, if two can play that, then you know what, you want to play that? Well, then we'll play rock and roll. You can't listen to that. Rock and roll is black. You don't believe me? Search it up. You also can't listen to Tupac, Biggie, or any type of hip hop, rap, or any artist whatsoever, because that belongs to black people. Shall we continue? Or, because I, like, do you see how dumb that sounds to gatekeep something that essentially anyone could listen to? I'm gatekeeping the pancakes that used to be called Aunt Jemima. I'm gatekeeping the syrup. I'm also gatekeeping potato chips, peanut butter. I'm gatekeeping peanuts. I'm also gonna gatekeep elevators, because elevators was invented by a black man. If you didn't know, elevators were invented by a black man. Let's see what else. I'm gonna look up a bunch of stuff invented by black people and gatekeep that, because you cannot buy any products that have been made by someone who was black. I'm just joking. Like, do you hear how insane you sound? Yes, I'm chronically online, and shall we play? I'll gatekeep the gym too, since we'll play into the fat phobia. Ice cream too. Ice cream, I'm taking it all, okay? I own everything now. I'm just kidding. I'm just joking, guys. I'm just joking. Excuse me. Who said I was playing Selena? I'm playing Jimin. But I will play Selena. What's my favorite Pokemon? Pikachu. I'll play Selena next. I don't take song requests, but give me a girl. I'm gatekeeping the water too. Move to my support? I'm not rude. Thank you for sharing. Do I like BTS? I don't know. Did Did I drive a Greyhound bus 12 hours to Vegas to see BTS and pay? It got a $230 ticket and sat up at like the 300 section and saw BTS live. Do I like BTS? I don't know. Do I? Do I have like 3 albums from BTS? 13, 12 hours. Yeah, because it takes that long. Unless you're flying, but obviously I'm terrified of heights, so flying is probably not for me in the future. I could already see me having a panic attack and not being able to get off the plane. I want to be able to live, okay? I've always had that thought process, you know, like, it happened to Aaliyah, it happened to Richie Valens. They both thought they were going to go down in an airplane. And that's why they never really wanted to ride airplanes. And I'm the same way. So, yeah. I don't like heights, so not for me. No, I don't think I would cut my hair. My hair is not growing. I need it to grow longer. So,
what's the point?
Why did I? I'm gonna order that shirt that says not famous. You're not famous, girl. I know I'm not famous. Why do people keep saying that? I know, okay? I am not famous. Not a famous person. Like, people literally act like if I'm treating myself as if I'm famous. No. No. Like, can we acknowledge how many times that I've told people I'm not a famous person? Thank you. I do, though. When have I? I said having a large following doesn't make you famous. Saying you are. I don't know. We'll play this song because I always have to. I have not eaten breakfast. Are you on the spectrum? No, I am not. So, something said, what happened? Somebody said, what happened? And for some reason, so what happened? Sponsor, what sponsor? I'm confused about what sponsor.
I could lose my heart tonight if you don't turn and walk away.
It was a joke, because if you guys know we all know Randall B. Gillis, right? He says he's famous because if you say Alexa, who is Randall B. Gillis, like, he's searchable, right? So I was being sarcastic and being like, well, if that's the case, then I would be famous because people could search me on Google. So then that makes me famous. I was being sarcastic because Randall's like, you could search me, so I'm famous. And I said, well, you could search me, so I'm famous. Like a joke. I know I'm not famous. Come on now. It was. A joke because of what Randall does. When I said, okay, my phone is dying. We gotta put it on the charger. Thank you for the tiny dimey. Tiny, 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 tiny. Oh my god, Jungkook's here. Sir, I'm just kidding. Wherever you go, I can fall in love. keep taking things with me.
And I know it's not right, and I guess I should try to do what I should do. And I fall in love.
Dreaming of You, I like that one. Como la flor? Flor? I said floor. I said that white. Floor? And I said that so confidently. Oh my god. Stop. Floor? Como la flor? Help. I am playing Selena. Or do you mean Selena Gomez? Because. Sorry, I didn't mean to say it like that. An ice cream roll up? I have the roll ups right here. Why? So you can hear the crunch?
I could fall in love. I could fall in love.
Not boy. This sucks. Hold on. I'm sorry. Not Gordon Ramsay. Help. Don't disrespect Gordon Ramsay like that, please.
Delicious pizza. There's also lava cakes, bread pies, and more.
Can you play some K-pop? I can. Yes, I'm talking about nothing, obviously.
And I wish on a star that somewhere you are thinking of me too. Here in my room, dreaming about you and me.
I'm sorry, the connection is like horrible.
Wonder if you know I'm there.
My nose.
Open my eyes. Would you see what's inside? Would you even care? I just wanna hold you close. So far, all I ever dreamed of.
I'm totally confused.
So I wait for the day. Courage to see how much I love you. I'll be dreaming of you tonight.
Every time I hear this song, I think of the end of the movie at a concert.
And there's nowhere in the world I'd rather be.
I'm recovering from being sick, so I'm also the greatest.
Dreaming about you and me. I can't stop dreaming.
Hey, here goes.
Dreaming away.
Como
Late at night when all the world is sleeping, I stay up and think of you. And you can't believe that you came up to me and said, sing.
I really do love this song.
Now I'm dreaming of you tonight, till tomorrow, and for all of my life. And there's nowhere in the world I'd rather be. Here in my room, dreaming with you and the sea. With you tonight.
Comments are going super fast. Hey guys,
I'd rather be. I'll be dreaming you tonight. Now I'm holding you.
My fave food is, my fave food is pizza.
With you tonight.
I know. Well, some people don't because they ask, okay? Where's she asleep? Next to my mom. What the heck is my mom doing? I don't know. My favorite vegetable is green beans. Green beans. Let me play this one. People want a K-pop, so I'll play this song. I just sit here. Well, what do you expect me to do? You're like, you just sit here. Of course I do. Wow. I don't have a vice for this group.
Thank you.
Jeez. Dance? I'm not gonna dance. moonlight, sunrise. Alcohol free is playing. I just was gonna be like, why did you turn off twice? Because I can. I haven't heard this song in a while. Sure, I can feel that. You can stop. Okay. I do know this song, actually, because I saw the English on YouTube. Anyways, while the caption. I'm not even mumbling. I didn't even say anything. Really? That's cool that you actually have a friend that's gonna debut in a group? I'm taking over you. It gives life. Are you gonna cry? No, I'm just listening to BTS. Why are you mad? I'm not mad. I'm not sad. I'm not anything. Thank you for the subscribers. Thank you for the compliment. How was my hair greasy when I took a shower? I don't see it as greasy. Thank you for the rose. About what happened? You're not sad about what happened? What happened? I'm taking over you. What happened? Maybe I'm an action figure. You know I'm an action figure. Oh, that House of Cards. Why did I have to play House of Cards? I was just, you know what? We'll have to let this play then. Are you talking about House of Mama? I already know she is. Thank you for the subscriptions. Oh, yeah, I'll play that next. Sorry. It started playing the song and I can't skip. TikTok has been freezing. Oh, God. Your Twitter. TikTok has been freezing. My Twitter. Are you talking about? I already talked about that verified account, guys. That is not me. Thank you for 1K. We got 1K. We hit 1K shares. Thank you. What happened? I don't know what's going on. Are you gonna dance? No. Guys, I know it's getting annoying to the point where I'm getting annoyed. I know that there is someone online talking about me. You don't have to tell me for the umpteenth time. I've already said that I know this person named House of Mama is talking about me on live stream. I don't know why. Okay, I know. It's getting annoying. I know. Okay, this song was requested. By who? Because there's the Gemini, there's Tech N9ne. I want you to cry for me. Someone wanted Red Nose, but I don't know by who. Sage the Gemini? Okay. I want you to cry, cry for me. I did not talk about BTS members, guys. Cry for me. Oh, I figured it was this one. You guys, I didn't say anything about BTS members. Okay, anyone could buy a verification badge on Twitter and pretend to be you. Okay, I don't know what to tell you. That's not a legit verification badge. They paid for it. Okay, next. After this, we play. So I was just thinking about something. Sorry, I cut. No, I wasn't saying. I was just thinking about something. Yeah. It's not the greatest, but it'll do. It'll do. That'll do. Awesome. Is that water? I don't know. Is it? Surprise. Water. Try not to cough. Jesus. Yes, it's wavy. I'm an action figure. You know I'm an action figure. you for the gift point.
Shouldn't figure.
Oh, I hate this. So trippy, so trippy. I have like this itchy, scratchy feeling, and then I cough.
I'm an action figure, you know I'm an action figure. Outrageous. An action figure. Huh? So trippy, so trippy.
Oh, this is something that I want.
Do.
That's what it sounds like, this song from T-Pain, like this part right here.
You do.
I mean, it did kind of get a little inspired by T-Pain. I'm not turning anything off.
Hey.
And so I'm gonna say yes, BTS. Are you referring to them, to this song as BTS? Because.
I'm an action figure.
It's charging, that's why sideways. I don't have a bias for wavy. Not by the moon, got 7. I haven't heard this song in so long, so. I know a lot about Wavy.
So you question, do you still love me? Have the time to you spend on your phone? Are you thinking of me?
That's some drinking water. Surprise.
Question. Wish you used to love me. If you do, I don't leave you. Little games in my head. I need the truth. Every little thing that I said, help me now. I'm getting caught up in 10 feet of water, staring at the bottom. Yeah, help me now. See the way I brought up all the shit I thought of. Tomorrow, yeah, help me now.
My throat is bothering me, and I'm trying not to cough. Also, chewing gum, which. Never seen when you're chewing gum.
Help me now.
Some.
Tell me what you're thinking.
I don't know about those people. I'm not joining their life.
I'm the best.
so annoying. So annoying.
Question. Do you wanna come in now? I'm getting caught up in 10 feet of water, staring at the bottle. Yeah, help me now. Sorry I brought up all the shit I thought of. Tomorrow, yeah, help me now.
Thank you, Sherry. Yes, guys, we know people are talking about me. It's an account called House of Mama. Like, stop. Anytime someone's talking about me, you guys want to engage in drama. I go live, I don't know why they're talking about me. I'm just literally live, like. But yeah, I'm the one that's always in drama, right? But I'm ignoring it.
I'm getting caught up in 10 feet of water, staring at the bottle, yeah, help me now. Sorry I brought up all the shit I thought of. Oh yeah, help me now.
No, I don't know, cause I went live. And I just went live because I hadn't been live, right? And I was just showing albums. I don't know why they're live. I don't know why they're talking about me. You're saying, like, you know why? I don't know why people talk about me, okay? I don't know. They can't be the moral police when that girl holds space for other black women to attack other black women. And all they do is just talk crap about black women. And she's a white woman who needs to stay in her place. I'm sick and tired of having to explain it to people. Don't give them the attention that they so clearly want. She had Strange Kevin on her live stream, literally defending Strange Kevin. She literally had, I don't know, just like, lag is annoying me to no end. She literally had Strange Kevin on her live stream defending Strange Kevin. She literally talks crap about Aunt Karen. And I'm not joining because all they do is they're about negativity. They always want to talk about people who have views so they could get them to their page. I'm not joining because people say join. I'm not going to join. I'm not giving that type of attention to people. Stop giving these people the attention that they're seeking. Please. Stop. It's annoying. Thank you.
Ooh, I'm missing you.
It froze. Cause why? I know. We're back.
We promise to make up even if it's gonna take us all of our lives. Promising to give it another try.
We need to do this right. Love, oh, you know me better. Ooh, you know you better. Oh, you know you better. Watch out. Cause boy, you know me better. You know me so much better. You know that I don't break up twice. What? Many men.
There. You want to talk, you're going to have to pay to talk. Stop saying joining. It's getting annoying. I'm not going to join their live stream. If they're going to leave, let them leave. Cool.
Wake up even if it's going to take us all of us. I'm willing to give it another try. We need to do this right. Love, it takes time. Boy, you know you better. You know you better. Boy, you know you better. Watch out. Boy, you know me better.
First of all, that lady, which I've been advocating for racism for black people, right? Well, not advocating, but I've been speaking up. What would it look like? You're saying I finally have a platform to clear my name, to go on a platform where this white woman was trashing Aunt Karen? Do you think it's okay, especially me, to go on a platform where this girl defended Strange Kevin? Do you think it's okay for me to go on a platform where this girl held a platform for black women to attack black women? What would it look like for me to go on my platform, thank you for the subscriptions, to clear my name on a platform that has been used to hurt black people? I'm not going on there. I have better common sense than that. And if y'all had the common sense, maybe you should say something to her about talking crap about Aunt Karen all the time. Some of y'all are two-faced. You really don't care about Aunt Karen because that girl talks crap about everyone. I'm not going on that platform to literally have clear my name or whatever. Accept it. I'm tired. I'm not going on there. I don't care who wants my views for what. I know what you mean. Yeah, they do just want views. They do this stuff to get views on their platform. They literally, that's why they mentioned Aunt Karen, because they wanted her to come on the platform. They do it for attention. Don't give them that attention, please. I don't know who this girl is. I only know her because when she was talking about AK, yes, and she was talking about another creator who I also follow too. You know, I won't break up twice. They go after large content creators and say, hop in the live, hop in the live. It's annoying. I personally do not want to join that live stream for a specific reason. All they do is go from one large creator to another large creator to another large creator and want views. I do not know. All I know is the girl, because she talks crap about people all the time, large content creators. And it's annoying. I know they're talking about me. I'm not joining her live stream. She is not a safe platform for people. So why would I join? Again. Well, I don't care. So what? That House of Mama always just wants clout from people. from what I've seen from her, all she ever does is try to call out large content creators. But she wasn't sitting there trying to say anything to Strange Kevin when she had him on her platform. She was defending him. So, like, what do you want me to do about it? Like, I know, I just went live to show, like, albums, you know, and then... But, yeah. This is why I subbed only, because it's annoying to say, to hear people say they're talking about you. Join. Like, I know the horrible person that she is. And from what I've been saying, me personally, with my large platform, it is not okay to give someone a platform like that. Who started beef? I didn't start anything. I went live and I was showing records. And the next thing I know, people are like, someone's talking about you. And I was like, did I ever say it was okay for me to do the things that I do? Have I ever said that anything I did was okay? I've addressed it. But they can't go around and go after large content creators and then say and expect them to join. It's not gonna happen. I'm not doing it. And people have to understand, I'm not doing it. I'm not. I'm gonna play this song.
Purdue University Global. Apply now at purdueglobal.edu.
Someone who Someone who hasn't had a positive platform for black people, I don't need their help. I'm sorry. I'm not going to go on their platform to ruin my platform even more. It's just not happening. I don't care if they want to help me. I don't care what their help is. Their platform is not a good platform to clear my name. I'm sorry. Not doing it. Like I said, I'm not going on anyone else's platform to do anything. If I want to defend myself, I have my own platform. I have my own live streams. Thank you for sharing. We hit the maximum shares. Thank you. But thank you for the gift points. You guys, just don't talk about them. It's not a good outlook when what she has done to black women is not a good outlook. I'm black myself. So if I go on her platform, it's not a good outlook on anyone. So no, it's not a good outlook. It'll look bad on me. And specifically the people that I follow and the people that follow me, what would it look like if I went on her platform knowing she did what she did? How would that look to me? That's like knowing what someone did and then proceeding to still go on their platform. No. I have to be careful, guys. Just like I said, we just have to... I'm not doing it. I'm just gonna ignore it. I'm just gonna ignore it. No, I didn't. But yeah, I'm not doing that. Thank you for the roses. I don't have a second account. What second account? Oh, I'm clearly stalking. Oh, here we go with that again. Just because someone is Asian does not mean I'm stalking. Like, I can't even support someone without people being like, I see you stalking. You're a fetish. Like, you just not mention that name in here, it just gets annoying. That's just like when you go to, like, their live stream is like, do you know? Oh, he didn't mention her, so he doesn't know her. Ha 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 ha. He's trying not to engage with the comments because it brings drama. And also because, obviously, he's trying to build his platform. He doesn't need that negativity on his page. Common sense. Like I said, I'm not allowed to join at all because of the negativity. Like, feels like I'm trying to scream over this music, sorry. It's just frustrating. It's just like, bro, could you, like, not? Like, can you not? I did turn it down. That's why I turned it down. No, he doesn't engage because he's in an agency. And because he can't have that negativity on his page. Thank you for the gift points. And that's what was told to me. So that's why I was not allowed to join, because people started harassing me there. Started saying, well, you're defending a pedophile and blah, 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 blah. So rather than have all that negativity that he can't have on his page, you have to understand, guys, people really care about getting sponsorships deals, okay? People want to build their platform. I'm not gonna get in the way of that. So it was advice to me. I've already told you guys this once. I cannot join anymore because of the negativity that the people from that dang Discord took to the live stream. Okay? Okay. And I said it that way because I have to censor the word, because words on TikTok are censored. And because of that, I cannot exist in that live stream. So, no. I'm not saying me. Well, yeah, of course I am trying to build my platform, but I'm saying for him, he's trying to build his platform, so I can't join anymore because people were negative, and it's hurt. I've been hurt, so whatever. And it's not only his live stream. People go to other people's live streams and start being hateful. Thank you for the subscription. It's just Thank you for the subscription. It's just I go on rant so people go like, no, I didn't. When I literally went live, I showed albums. I didn't go on a rant. I just literally showed albums when I went live. I was like, look at the albums I got. And then people start being negative, being like, you're spending money, you don't pay for your necessities, and blah, 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 even though it was like $5, and some of those albums were $1, and people can't take into the account people had changed or something, like, I didn't want to hear it at all. Thank you for sharing. I mean, well, when there's so much of it, kind of, but I do complain because I'm tired of it. It's like, you know, like Nova, I complain because Nova's like, I hate her so much, but yet he has never blocked me. Like I said, if y'all hate me so much, why do you watch me? It was like the girl who used me as an example, and people just like discredited what she was talking about. And then in her comment section said, be freaking for real, she's not black. The only way people are gonna stop with that is if I slap a DNA test online to prove that that's my real dad. That's just the only way. You know, like, if you guys want to be like Maury Povich, I guess, since you want to make this like Maury Povich, the only way people are going to stop with that is if I actually just like show like, hey, my DNA test, that's my dad. Like, that's crazy. I'm not talking about anyone, I'm talking about this video that someone made. Someone made a video using me as an example, and and I'm tired of it. I hear it in the Discord when Isaac keeps sharing that stupid video that says you don't even know who your daddy is, and it's the black woman that's like, you don't even know who your daddy is. Like, it's annoying. He needs to quit it and leave me alone. Like, it's getting frankly annoying. Plus a few extras. Lickety split. And even on my mom's station head, they're like, didn't you tell us that was her stepdad? Didn't you say your parents were together before you was born, and this equates to this, so this means that's not your real dad when I said they were together a year before I was born? It takes 9 months to make a baby, so do the math. If it takes 9 months, thank you for the subscription, to make a baby, then that should tell you something. If they were together a year before I was born and it took 9 months to make me, I mean, like, of course you paid to hate. Of course you subscribed to hate. Like, it's like a every day thing that I see videos. I see some, or someone DMs me. Of course they're gonna have that question, and I'm not gonna be rude because they see other people who keep pushing this narrative all over TikTok that I'm lying about my age. Or, I mean, not age, that I'm lying about being black. Sorry, my brain. Not only that, yeah, they do also say I'm lying about my age, but Anyways, but they say, oh, you're lying about being black. They're going around telling people that I'm not black. It's just like, why would I come online and do that? Do you not see my hair? Like, this isn't my real hair, by the way, according to people. It's a wig. Like, I'm frustrated at this point. And I'm also frustrated about that Twitter. That was the worst idea. The worst idea Twitter ever had was to allow people to pay for a verification. The worst. Because you have people imitating people. Did you not even stop to think about that? So it's okay for when people pretend to be Elon. It's okay for when people pretend to be Elon. Because that account, we lost connection. Sorry, I don't know, for some reason TikTok has been weird and we lost connection. Because that account is saying the most disgusting, hateful things. Like, they're using slurs, they're saying a whole bunch of stuff, and there's nothing I could do about it. And they're using my name. And it literally has kindness in the username. How are you gonna have kindness in the username and you're not even being kind? Or even using kindness? That's crazy. The fact that someone went to the extent of wasting their money to pay for a verification is crazy. And I think the chat froze, so I think we're losing connection. Thank you for subscribing. Do you know Spanish? Un poquito, I know a little bit. Like, the fact that you paid for a subscription to pretend to be me on Twitter is crazy. Oh, Charlie Wilson. Hey. Like, it's frustrating because I don't have anyone to help with that. You know, if I had, like, a actual manager, not, like, a TikTok livestream manager who can't do nothing outside of other social media apps, that'd be crazy. Did I say subscription? Is that what I said? No, I don't. But anyways, thank you for sharing. My content was not good enough. Not the stuff I done. My content is what they said. But people want to believe what they want to believe, so. Thank you for sharing. No, I really don't, because then people start complaining about the song request that I take. Thank you for the subscriptions. We got another free subscription, guys. Yay. Now we have 9 free subscriptions to give away. Woohoo. We got 9. Thank you for the gift points. You know. Plain water is gross, but I needed to drink it because I was coughing. It's a scratchy feeling. How am I? I'm good. How are you? Thank you for the chicken leg. Espa released a new song. Thank you for the gift points. Is that how you say it, Espa? Thank you for the gift points. Yeah, a little better. It's just my nose is plugged. Yeah, so I am better, obviously, because I've been out, but it's just my nose. The reason I because obviously I don't go anywhere sick. I'm not gonna get everyone else sick. Okay. I do drink I heard something about cold water not being good for you, but I don't know. Thank you for the roses and the gift points. Why are people saying? Because I got a couple of shirts. Because I don't have all my clothes. It's buried in storage somewhere. Storage is a whole mess. And I got a couple of albums and they're like, oh my god, you went on a shopping spree. Like, you spent money and you're not caring about your necessities. And it's just like, bro, I only spent $5 and a couple of dollars on some albums. I'm not spending money constantly left and right. Of course, I know. I'm saving to get into an apartment. Like, I had change saved. Ew. Thank you for the gift points. PlayStation fan I'm not on the PlayStation 4. That's my brother's PlayStation. I haven't been on it. I've been on the Xbox though, Xbox One. I don't have those systems are not mine, so yeah. I've been playing on the PlayStation. I think WrestleMania's on. I better put it on soon. He doesn't really play his PlayStation 4. He's not on it, so. We're mostly on the Xbox. She is having a dream because you could hear her. Anyways, why don't you ever? That's so nice. DMs, I am. When is merch coming out? I'm not doing merch. Like I said, I want to do a clothing line, but not merch. Yeah. Someone said to make, you know, the Mickey Mouse painting that everyone makes fun of? They said I should make merch of that. Yeah, I'm not ignoring you. I'm reading the comments. Do you have any designs yet for your line? So I'm going to look more into this because I want to get some ideas and stuff. So there's this place, but you have to be careful with like stuff with like AI and stuff like that. I had talked about this. There's this video I saw on YouTube, and this guy said you pay $8 and it creates a personal, whatever you type in, it creates a personalized, or a personalized, like, for you. You're paying for the design, basically, to keep the design, to do whatever you want with the design. That's basically what you're paying for, right? That's what you're paying for, is for to keep the design, for the design, because obviously it's not free. NFTs, I heard NFTs are bad. I wanted to like buy NFTs, but I heard they're bad, and I wanted to do NFTs, but that's bad. Apparently, I don't know if it's, is it Bitcoin or is it NFTs? It's bad for the environment. That movie's on. The movie with Sandra Bullock. I forget what movie. It's, The Blind Side. That's what it is. NFTs are bad, though. So, yeah, I have something important that I'm doing Monday. So, hopefully we'll see how well that does. And then, yeah, I need to just I don't know what it's called. Vendor? Someone said vendors, but I don't think it's vendors. It's like a manufacturer. You know, where you could, like, people could order through the company and they just ship out, like, clothes. I could do it through drop shipping, because it's free and I have an account on both places. Teespring and Spreadshirt, I could, you know, for the time being, until I'm able to, like, set up. Yeah, I also saw a lot about drop shipping too. So, what someone said you could do, so Shopify, you can sign up for a free trial, and you could do you can't change if you want to sell another product. You can only sell one product. And there's a place that I forgot. I have to look it up again. It tells you, like, what are top selling items, what's going to trend, like, what item is, like, selling the most of. And then what you can do is you can drop ship that item, if that makes sense. So, yeah. Well, I'm not gonna do shipping if people think that it's, like, people are gonna think a lot about drop shipping because we see all those, a lot, like, okay, so I've kinda also feel like drop shipping is saturated already. There's, like, too many people doing it. And then you have those people that's like, you can make money with no money. And then that's just, like, a lie. No, you cannot. You cannot. And they just, like, make things look bad. Like, those people that do, like, the drop shipping stuff. I bought this $1 million home just doing drop shipping. And it's like, or are you selling the fact? Or it's like basically like selling to people, right? They're selling this program of how they did drop shipping, which I've never understood that, because it's like people trying to sell this product. Yeah, I know. It's like people trying to sell the like classes that are like, become a famous YouTuber just like me, and you can buy this package to become not a famous YouTuber, but become a successful YouTuber and make money just like me. The only thing you need to do, to be totally honest with you, is just start filming YouTube videos. Film a YouTube video, post it on YouTube. Have a creative thumbnail that no one else has that makes you unique and stands out from other people. You don't need someone to tell you how to be a successful YouTuber. Why pay for it? Why pay for it? Oh, make money just like us. It's like they're making money because they're selling this, like, become a successful YouTuber like me. They're like off of people's hopes and dreams. That is a harsh reality. Because it's just like, I have to log in on my computer, and it's not letting me. It says that Sims. It says I need the SMS login. Because I logged back in. Okay, so I logged back in on my phone, is what happened. On my Android, like a dummy, I should have logged in on the computer first. I would have gotten in. But since I'm logged in on both devices, which is my iPhone and my Android, it won't let me log in on a third device. So it's saying that it won't let me log in on my computer because it's saying that for some reason, it's saying that it needs SMS verification because I've logged in too many times. It wants to be safe, for me to be safe, that someone else is not logging in. And they want it to make sure it's me, but the number that I have, okay, so the number that I have on my TikTok, I no longer have that number. I tried changing it. There's a way to change it, but then it makes you enter in a code that it sends to the old number that I no longer have. So it doesn't make sense, it doesn't help, and it sucks. So, and I need to get maybe my community manager who does TikTok Live. I don't know, I'd have to ask. I don't think she could, or I don't know if it's a... Well, anyways, not she, but I don't think they could help me outside of live streams to get in contact with TikTok to change my number, because I need that number changed. I need it changed. That's difficult. So because of that, I don't know when the series is coming, but it is. Several people got it, I'm pretty sure, already. So TikTok rolled this thing out called series, where you do educational and informational series. And people, if they want to watch it, they can buy it. But what's weird to me is it says that it says educational and informational series. But it says, add your most best videos from like TikTok, and most best videos or something like that from TikTok, and people could pay to watch it. And I'm like, why would people pay to watch videos they've already seen? That doesn't make sense. But so people requested that I do, sorry, a true crime series, like do true on true crime. I don't know if TikTok will allow that. Now they're getting strict, so I don't know if they will allow true crime. I don't know if they will allow it, but they wanted me to do true crime. But yeah, so because of that, so, and, that. I have to do something real quick. Anyways, back to what I was talking about. So, yeah, because TikTok's getting strict, I have to kind of be careful. So, yeah, once I'm able to log in on the computer, I will work on the series, and then I will post the series up. But yeah, it is hot and humid in here. I think my mom's watching that movie. Hopefully it's almost over. But yeah. Oh no. Hold on. I think it's at the end of the movie. Were you doing? I'm gonna put on, yeah, it is. I'm gonna put on, I don't ski, guys. WrestleMania. It's on, or it's gonna come on. Hey, Krusty. Where's the remote? Hey, Krusty. Oh, it's not plugged in. Oh Lord, hold on, guys. I was listening to a record, and that's why I have it unplugged. It's unplugged. Ah. Okay. I don't think that plug on the end works. There we go. Sorry, guys, hold on.
Your
life, or what? Oh no. WrestleMania is on. Well, it's coming on. You're funny, I see.
All I feel is the heater's on. It's not on.
No, it's not on. It's hot in here.
But it's me.
No, I feel it hot.
You need to turn it on for a little bit. You can.
I'll put the
cooler.
Yeah. Doesn't that movie come out? Ooh, hold on. Let me push the chair in. My mom's going to the restroom. Hats are falling. Xbox. Has that movie come out today on Peacock? That one movie with, I think it's Chloe Bailey. I'm not gonna watch it, but sorry guys, hold on. Ah, it took too long to start. Also that quiz time, I could like play. I don't know if I need a camera to stream, cause it says I can do a live. And we could do like quiz time. But I don't know. Because I don't know how to stream it if I don't have a camera. I mean, I know people said like Twitch or TikTok. I don't mean like that. Like, you could stream from the Xbox. And then some people wanted to play it, but it's taking forever. I don't know if I. I don't know if it's connected to the Wi-Fi. There we go. I think. There we go. Okay. Got it.
Gosh. Hey, success in this business is 90% physical and the other half is mental. Now listen up. If you find a toilet in your dreams, don't use it. And always remember, I don't care how nice the soap is, never come out of the bathroom sniffing your finger.
You seem a bit confused. Maybe you need Snickers. Snickers satisfies.
Okay. We got it, guys. Song. This might be the replay. I remember, man. Well, I got like the free. What is it? When you sign up, you get a free trial.
Tonight only, free shipping on qualifying orders.
Even though, like, it says $4.99, which is pretty cheap, but I remember when you used to have to order through pay-per-view, like WrestleMania, it was like $50. It's pretty cheap.
Hey, should you be drinking that?
It's me, because we're busy women. We don't have time for a lag of buffering. Who doesn't want internet that helps AI do your homework even faster?
Come again?
Sorry, what was that?
Introducing the next generation 10G network, only from Xfinity. The future starts now.
Watch the fallout as the survivor.
My favorite match? I did like seeing John Cena. I did like Lita's match. I also like Charlotte's match because her dad was one of my favorite wrestlers, Ric Flair. Are you talking about WWE? Yes. You didn't know, guys? I watched WWE a lot, like all the time.
5 hour energy got you through then.
I've been a huge WWE fan.
We'll get you
for as long as I can remember. I don't really watch, so I haven't been keeping up with new wrestling, if that makes sense. It's been years since I kind of stopped watching wrestling, where I was like, you know what, let's watch WrestleMania, why not? But yeah. out with Bad Bunny.
For some reason, they all ended up being dogs.
Okay, it might not lag anymore. Or we'll see. Hopefully it doesn't lag. We'll see. I connected to my data. I really don't like Brock Lesnar.
WrestleMania has played host to some of the biggest collisions in WWE history.
Undertaker, Kane.
Two titans are set for
okay. So this is a question that I still have answers to this day. Maybe it was answered. Is Undertaker and Kane really brothers, or was it just like a script for like the wrestling? Cause I remember like them saying Undertaker and Kane were brothers.
With a wingspan of 81 inches, Brock Lesnar has the ultimate tool to deliver the
F5. Like,
so it's no surprise.
That's a question that is dumb to ask, because I know obviously it's scripted, but are they really actually brothers?
The Beast even took his talents from the squared circle to the octagon, becoming UFC heavyweight champion. Brock Lesnar is capable of decimating any person who stands in front of him.
I don't like Brock Lesnar, to be honest with you. It is still, it's still lagging.
7'3".
And it's happening because of TikTok. TikTok is doing this stupid major update, so it's not working.
Omos' 87-inch reach would give him nearly a foot-long advantage over the average heavyweight fighter.
You will not defeat him at WrestleMania.
With these two monsters clash in Hollywood, it's going to be a battle like no other. It's Brock Lesnar versus Omos on the only stage big enough to contain.
We keep losing connection because of the stupid TikTok. I connected to data and it's still doing that. And TikTok has been laggy. But Brock Lesnar, I was talking about, goes from UFC to WWE to UFC to WWE to UFC to WWE. And it's so annoying because it's like, pick one or the other.
This one is totally different because Omos, I mean, he has untapped power, untapped potential. We really don't know how good Omos actually could be, but we do know this. If he can beat Brock Lesnar, he's going to...
That guy is jumping really high.
That place I like to call the Nebula, baby. All the way out there, past the stratosphere, past those 10 stars, man. So this guy's future could be right after...
We hit 202 subs. Yeah. Thank you. We're back at 200.
When Omos took Brock over the top rope, knocked him out.
Yeah, I saw that. I actually saw that. I thought it was cool. Was it when I was fighting Nova? I think it was me versus Nova or something. I thought that was funny. I don't know if that's the one, the video. I don't know if that's the one you're talking about. I think that's the video I saw of the 2K23. Yes, we hit 203. My favorite types of chips are Fritos or Cheetos or Doritos. That rhymes. Fritos, Cheetos, Doritos. They're chanting. Not Cheetos. Cheetos are good. I don't know who's gonna. Jesus, I'm not gonna throw up. I just have a dry cough. I've had since I've been sick, loss of appetite. I didn't eat dinner yesterday. I didn't eat breakfast today. I don't feel like eating. I don't know what it is.
That is a great question. And you're right. And this is the unthinkable in so many ways. Brock Lesnar losing his WrestleMania match too. In many ways, yes, he's 7'3", he's 410 pounds. He was weighed on the weighing machine last week on Raw.
I heard you say that. I started Googling what a weight. Did everyone forget a word?
Yeah. So, thank you for sharing the live.
I can't imagine that happening.
I know, guys, I know. Also, I keep forgetting to add more emotes. I'm gonna do that soon.
Imagine a beast incarnate with a shattered ego. Brock Lesnar will become a shell of his former self if he cannot conquer the giant tonight.
But on the flip side, if a match, what the WrestleMania.
Thank you for sharing, guys.
Brock Lesnar could F5 the giant.
I know. I know. I will. I'll do it.
All right. We're gonna make some picks. Hopefully, these gentlemen are anywhere close by listening to
us
today.
20 years impervious to all opponents. Finally tonight, Brock Lesnar comes undone. Omos wins. You know, what? This is something totally different that we've ever seen since Andre the Giant.
Is it Saboni? Yeah, it's on Saboni. I have to find the headrest.
I'm gonna go on Moss tonight.
They booed him because he said Brock Lesnar. This still has flavor.
Smart man.
Slowly losing flavor. Are they booing both guys? They don't like both of them? Hershey won't come over here. Hussey! If she's asleep, she won't come. Tori Wilson! Mick Foley. That was a once in a lifetime for me, was meeting Mick Foley. I was like, I had to meet Mick Foley. I had to. Jerry the King Lawler.
Jerry, thank you so much. He got into wrestling because
Andy Kaufman.
Long fan.
So, if you don't know, because my mom watches these old shows. So, Man in the Moon. It's a movie called Man in the Moon, I think. Man on the Moon, whatever. And it's a movie about the guy. There's a show my mom watches called Taxi. And it has Danny DeVito and a bunch of other A-listers, I think. Anyways, so Andy Kaufman is in that show, Taxi. And so Jim Carrey played him in a movie. So what happened was, is that Jerry the King Lawler, to revitalize his career, right, he thought it would help people like him more if he wrestled Jerry the King Lawler. He started wrestling women. His gimmick was wrestling women. Andy Kaufman. He started wrestling women, and then he started wrestling men. Like, and then he wanted to fight Jerry the King Lawler. And it was a skit, because, you know, it's scripted. So they scripted for him to fight Jerry the King Lawler, and it ruined his career. Actually, it was like a career ruiner. So it ruined his career. They thought it would help his career, and it didn't. They said it, he was like, I'm sorry. He was like, it just ruined his career. At that point, they didn't like him. But yeah, he fought and wrestled Jerry the King Lawler, because they were showing him there, Andy Kaufman. So apparently at the end of the movie, there's a scene at the end of the movie, they believe that, I don't know, there's this guy that, okay, so he has two characters, right? There's him, which is Andy Kaufman, which is, he plays Laka, his name is Laka, on, Taxi. But he had another character named Tony Clifton, and Tony Clifton was this really raunchy guy, who, did, like, sort of kind of raunchy comedy. People didn't like him. He literally dressed up and did that. Well, apparently when Andy Kaufman died, he did a show, Tony Clifton did, and people believed that they were like, well, how is this person doing this character and it isn't him? Or his partner who plays him, and he's not living. Like, who's this person that is playing this character? And so because of that, there had been a conspiracy or speculation that Andy Kaufman was alive and that he didn't really go. Hershey, come here. Come on. Come here, come here, come here. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you. I have to, I could apply or, like, try to sign up to see if they'll let me do cameos, but I don't really want to do cameos. Yeah, because people was annoying me about that other live stream, and I didn't want to have to deal with that, so I did sub only.
Dominic Mysterio lost that match last night, but in that moment, I truly believe he solidified himself as a in this industry. Was that, look, there are moments like that when you can lose the match, but it changes your career because of the performance.
I say Dominik's stock went way up after last night, because he went in there and he proved that he is an entertainer, a guy that's going to go out and perform at the highest level under the brightest light. You got to give that kid a big pat on the back.
Yeah, and Dominik Mysterio, he's just going to get better and better. He's still young.
Yeah, it's not so much craziness with comment, but yeah.
Gonna be amazing.
Happy birthday, D. But yeah.
Gonna be amazing.
Happy birthday, D. Thank you for the gift points. But yeah, he has to go check the mail. Bobby Lashley's been wrestling for so long. Jeez. I don't know why these people slam everything and they're so loud. I know I talk loud and I'm pretty loud, but they do it on purpose. We lost connection. They literally do it on purpose. And there's this guy who's been hollering and yelling and I don't know, whoever. And like sometimes they knock on the walls on purpose. When they hear a dog bark, they do it on purpose so she could bark more, and it's just like annoying.
It's got its own beach, the birthplace of America, where you're always reminded that life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness isn't just a saying, but a way of life.
It gets annoying because they do it on purpose. Thank you for sharing.
With a no-quit attitude, because there's tough, and then there's Philly tough. Next day, the knockout punch is coming. And that, there's a Philly game.
WrestleMania is going to Philadelphia. I don't know. They just knock on purpose because when they hear Hershey bark, they start knocking, and it's annoying.
Liz, they're ready for your WrestleMania performance.
They call me the A-lister. I am the superstar in all of the WWE. And that is why they asked this guy to host WrestleMania.
You think I'm gonna say that? I know what that is. I'm not gonna say that.
It's coming.
WrestleMania is coming to Hollywood. Do you feel yourself succumbing?
It's coming.
I hope you all are coming. It's gonna be good. The biggest of all. Bigger than stupendous. Two enormous blockbuster nights.
Oh jeez, I have a drink off. Well, I stopped for a moment because I was like, because you know the Simpsons were, Bart, he calls Moe's Tavern, and he always leaves those like prank calls. That's why I was like, it's one of those.
About to find out.
Where he calls it, he's like, "Hi, I'm looking for L." last name Caholic? Well, it's like, is there an alcoholic? Is there an alcoholic? Is anyone here an alcoholic? Or when he's like, whatever else he says. I forget the other ones. Thank you for following. Oh, Jesus Christ.
I'm not gonna lie, that was a very well done. That's it. From singing in front of people is very difficult. So he did a great job there, much better there than he did last night.
Well,
let's
talk about the Miz last night.
Oh wow. Pat McAfee gave me a call. He said, "Hey, any chance you would be interested in hopping in over the, you know, over the railing, be a part of WrestleMania?" I was like, "Yeah, sounds great. Where do I sign?"
You sat there waiting for the moment. Yeah, he gave you the look.
Gave me the look. It was awesome. Got over a little bit. Miz was fantastic for it, but. It was just really fun to be able to share the ring.
What did he say to you here, The Miz?
Oh, I was having to get back in the ring, and he was just like, you know what, sit down. Just sit down. You have nothing to do with this. And
there he goes, looking, taking off the jacket. It's almost like he's a Pro Bowl tight end.
Yeah. Miz, what are we doing?
We didn't get you involved, bro.
This guy, Pat, just front flipping off the swan. I got to tell you, Pat's too rich to be doing that.
Get up. Clean your kitchen. Do it! Just do it! I'm just kidding. Well, yeah. Do it. Just do it. If you don't clean that kitchen, who's gonna clean the kitchen? Because it's just gonna stay dirty until you clean it. That's just like me. I hate dishes, right? The longer you stare at the dishes, they're not gonna clean themselves. You can't just stare at the dishes and expect the dishes to clean themselves and be like, I don't want to do those dishes. Like, the longer you stare at it, the more time you waste not getting it done. Just get it done and over with.
Mr. H, they have my phone number. I'll always return those calls, baby.
Nice, all right. I wrote the promo for you. My name's George Kittle, and just like a Skittle, I'll make you break down and taste the rainbow.
Hey, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir. Hey, welcome to tonight, George. Yeah. Which match are you looking forward to the most? Tonight? Ooh. I mean, Cody versus Roman. That's a fantastic main event. Huge. I'm super excited about that. I'm really looking forward to the cage match. The demon versus Edge. That's gonna be wild. It's gonna be dark. It's gonna be violent. We're looking forward to that one. The demon doesn't lose very often, so I'm going with him. I love Finn. He's fantastic. He tried to interfere last night too. He's just all over the place. Big fan.
Sorry.
Is there any next year after you score a touchdown, you throw up that we the one? Would you ever do such a thing as
don't
a celebration
for
Roman? Oh, who knows? Hey, I mean, love it. So
just gonna
Roman.
Send it. I'm not gonna.
Was lost last night, but
an historic run, and it had to come to an end eventually.
And to two fantastic people too, between KO and Sammy. Like that, what an event last night, dude. That was amazing. What, so what that was awesome. But yo, hey, who knows? You throw that up for Roman, he's almost at 1,000 days. Crazy.
It's pretty amazing. So you're, as a fan, you'd be devastated to see the bloodline completely crumble here if Roman loses tonight.
You know,
wait, what? That's crazy. She holds like group meetings? They're called group meetings about me? That's crazy.
It's the real reason you like the bloodline, because they're all full.
I didn't know she was holding group meetings. That's weird. Thank you for following me.
But yes, the fact that they like the Bang Bang Niner gang. I love that.
Thank you so much, and again, so much luck for you today, WrestleMania, the Hollywood, Nashville, and we have that for just disgusting Cody Rhodes game that obviously needs to go out and play with another.
I got a lot of messages. Thank you for following and for sharing. It's the count is like Tofia, and then it has like a black dot in the middle, and it says Kindness Era. And it says, so the account literally says, gorgeous, he had been exposed for sounding like Mickey Mouse, be for real. And it's literally an account that is commenting on like things about BTS. They're commenting on things about like celebrities, and they're verified. They paid to be verified. They took a picture, the profile picture that I have for this account, they took that and they added it to make an account. They literally added that picture and made an account and paid to get it verified, and they're saying a bunch of it's bad stuff. It's my name, and like there's literally nothing I could do about it because I told people to report and they were like, we can't find the account. So I don't know. So yeah. But yeah.
Bianca! Your destiny's written all over the sky.
The twisted tale of Oscar.
Anyways. So apparently that Temu app, because I talked to someone about it. The only thing, I'm not going to mention names, but the only thing that person said is they heard it was a scam. I don't know much about Temu because people have been sending me a Temu link. And it's like, join my link so I can earn money. Thoughts on the drag band? It's horrible. So I've been getting a bunch. Okay, so America, the government, the states have been getting very dangerous with their laws. And one state, if anyone could tell me what state it is literally passed a law to force trans children, because I don't want to get into like really tough subjects because TikTok's kind of getting strict. They passed a law to force trans children to detransition. And that is dangerous and scary. And we do have to acknowledge that the people that you elect, you elected these people, right? And I'm not saying you, but people did. And we need to go out and vote for people who are actually going to make a difference. They're so fixated on trans people, the LGBTQ, it is insane the amount of videos I've seen. I cried. There was a video, I don't know, I reshared it. The girl cried from what she heard some lady over say at the grocery store. I'm trying to like not bring triggering or words that might be censored from TikTok, but her and her friend were openly being transphobic, and the girl was just crying, and it made me upset because I've been seeing all these videos where trans people can't exist. Then you have that dumb, I'm sorry, it is stupid, the Jim Crow law that was just passed. Thank you for following and for sharing. This whole world, there's just something wrong with it, right? And I feel like people need to do more about it. It's like, what can you do? Like, besides voting. Like, it sucks when you vote and people don't vote the right people into office.
You never see her unnerved. You never see her concerned. You never see.
No, I haven't.
Because she can handle anything that gets.
Well, like, what can you do? Literally. About. What's going on?
Bianca Belair has no.
Like, besides voting, it just feels like. Sometimes you feel powerless because I see all these people hurting, like the trans, the LGBTQIA plus community is hurting. I see what's happening to my people, minorities, and it's so difficult. Like, it's what's happening to women. It's so stressful because it's like, what can you do?
Superstars that have been in this business. And while talking about the great Buddha, Ric Flair put Asuka on that.
Yeah, game. See, the thing about protesting.
So, no one should be sleeping on the Empress of Tomorrow, that's for sure.
We don't have a lot of protests here. Okay, I'm gonna tell you a funny story about a protest. So, I don't know what this. I don't remember. Well, actually, we don't really know what the protest was. My brother was downtown, right? And all of a sudden, these people just came out of hiding from nowhere, right? These people weren't hiding. They came out of nowhere. I'm talking like out of nowhere. And they came together and started protesting for nothing. I don't know what it was. It was like downtown at night, and they came out of nowhere and just started protesting. I was like, you know, I don't really want, I know, like, I shouldn't say I don't want to put my life in danger for people, but, like, a protest, you know, the way the police treat people during protests is, they always want to make it seem like people, especially when it's a protest for like Black Lives Matter or when it's a protest against police brutality, they always want to make it seem like we're the ones who are the violent people when it's not. It's the police who literally do things for no reason. Here, when Donald Trump came, no one liked Donald Trump. And at the convention center, they smashed windows. They were on top of cop cars. I don't know if the police on horses were there, but there was like a whole bunch of people who got tear gassed. It was bad. So I was like, that was at the time. That's when Donald Trump had came. And Donald Trump literally called us hooligans or something. I don't know what he said. He said something about us because because people started a protest and it wasn't good about Donald Trump because they didn't like him. Thank you for following. I got a free subscription. Can we see her? She won't come. Let's see.
Oh.
You're back. Now
you're in my arm.
I'm sorry.
Give them what they want.
Hey, hussy. Come here.
Let's get into it.
Okay, I need to do this walk.
Come on. She won't come. She's not coming at all. Come on, Hussy. Come on. Come here. They want to see you. I don't know if you'll see her. Because, she's jumping down. Come on. Oh, thank you. Yeah, you can't see because it's green screen.
Yeah, I got one. How about the best network imaginable? Let's invent that.
We don't have time for a lag of buff, right?
Thank you, Hushy.
Come again? Sorry, what was that?
The next generation 10G network only from Xfinity.
Live TV is not like anything else. You don't know what's next.
Open the door!
And that's what happens watching On Patrol live on Reels, now on Peacock.
Put the gun down!
Shut it down!
Pursuit, he's not stopping.
Everybody in the car, put your hands open!
Here you go. People wanted to see you, Hussie.
We're on patrol live as we are every Friday and Saturday night on Reels.
There you go.
On Peacock.
Peacock is now streaming your favorite morning news shows live.
Good morning, everybody. Let's get started.
Get the stories you need to start your day.
Okay, okay.
You love.
Got a lot to get.
I think she wants to get down. Get down.
Live from the Nasdaq market site.
Join the conversation.
There you go.
Agenda in DC on Morning Joe.
So much is it.
She wants to go back to sleep.
Top stories on NBC News now.
We're following.
That's where she went. She went back to sleep. Okay. I have to get off soon, guys. I'm gonna have to get off soon and get something to eat. Oh, Sub only was on because I was getting annoyed with comments. So, yeah. I'm gonna have to get off to get something to eat, and I have stuff to do. Mukbang? No, I don't have money. Guys, I have to save.
The undisputed WWE Universal Championship will be on the line as Roman Reigns defends against Cody Rhodes, but like I always like to do, I like to go to the people to get their opinions on who's going to win this match. So, to my right, we have...
Emily.
And to my left, we have...
Diego.
And by the way, it's Diego's birthday. Happy birthday, Diego. And in the back, I got Rose, our special enforcer, just to make sure nothing crazy happens, okay? All right. Going with you first. Cody Rhodes, Roman Reigns, who leaves WrestleMania as champion?
Absolutely, without a doubt, it's Roman Reigns.
Why the heck? That's crazy. This girl is smashing into several cars trying to get away. Like, she tried to rob this old lady, and then she took her car instead and smashed into a bunch of cars. Like, you literally, okay, you have to be the dumbest person alive to smash into a bunch of cars and not get away. You obviously weren't gonna get away anyways. Even if you got away in the car, you have to pay for all those cars you smashed because you have to pay for that. And you have to literally go to jail. Like, it doesn't make sense, you know? Thank you for the Iscorn, you guys.
But
Yeah, so.
And after 20 years of complete domination, Brock Lesnar goes up against the 7'4", 400-pound Nigerian giant Omos. Has the Beast Incarnate finally met his match?
He's 7 feet 4 inches. Hold up, guys. Boots.
Into the main event of WrestleMania Sunday. For 945 days, Roman Reigns has been running WWE. In his way tonight, the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes. It's Roman's legacy versus Cody's story. At 8 years old, I knew not what I wanted to do, what I needed to do.
This is your dream, this is what you want. You want to complete the comeback, huh?
To finish the story.
Being in the main event with Roman Reigns, that's your dream. And that's where the story ends.
So anyways, guys, I was trying to do something for I'll to do it later when I go back live again. Yeah, I need to get off because I haven't eaten anything. Have a good day or night where you guys are. I will see you guys later. I'll be live later. I'll go live later. Okay, guys, I'll try. I always say that and then I don't, but I'll make an effort to go live later. Okay, have a good day or night where you guys are, and I will see you guys later. Okay, guys. Bye, guys. Bye, guys. Guys, I'm not buying food. Have a good day or whatever you guys are. I'll see you guys later. I'm lying. I said I have to go eat. Obviously, I have something to eat. But I will see you guys later.